Hello, welcome to Atom RPG version 1.07. So they change a lot of things, but to be honest, if you're starting the game out right now, the changes are very, very good because they explain a lot of things to you. They also fix some quests in Beregon, they also fix some quests in the castle. Some typos and weird phrasing in the game were fixed as well. But the biggest fix for me at least was the random encounters balance. So they're a little bit more balanced now, but I don't know, that depends on your game and how you are feeling them. I mean, I can't say that this is a major change because it will work differently for other people, and some people, I don't know, maybe they'll expect something else from them, but they were fixed and they are better now. And they also fixed some other things, including optimization, but to be honest, the biggest thing they really did for the game is at the Atom HQ. By the way, I'll start the game right now. I have 60 lockpicking and I'll show you why. Action hero. Action man, the greatest hero of them all. Okay, we actually got the achievement, the savant, if you're interested in that. So that's why I did it like that, 11. Okay, so we basically wake up from a nightmare in the Atom Age court. Actually, this is the Atom surroundings. Or what did he call them? Okay, I think this is the guy that you meet in the final mission of the game. He's outside the mushroom bunker. And he just says, no, I don't care. I don't want to enter and fight the mushroom people. I just want to take over the city. Okay, they should also change this wording because no military personnel would ever use this. This is the outside portion of the Atom HQ. No, this is the ground level or the, I don't know, the training facility or something else. They shouldn't call this the outside portion. Okay, he's feeling a bit of a hangover or something like that. Anything to help you sleep last night, comrade? Crackhead is 2005. Don't scare me like that. This is actually good because it tells you what year you're on, and that's very, very good for the story. Okay, first thing you have to do is to eat. A bit strange, but hey, okay. The glorious poster of the... I don't want to say too many things about that also. This guy is right here, the hero of the common people. And lower than that you have... I don't want to think about that. Okay, now you have a little quest. How to get outside without using lockpick. Okay, then let me show you some things that are in here. You need to grab the key from there. And another interesting thing is right here. Actually, it was the first locker. I think this is a new item because I didn't see it in the game. It's a coin with the image of a drink or something on it. You put the coin in your hand and you can actually use it to buy a drink. Fizzy drink dispenser. The atomic fizzy drink, yeah, this is like Coca-Cola, only a little stranger looking. This is more like a rocket or a UFO or something like that. But I think they should change this. You shouldn't get drunk after drinking the fizzy soda because this is a training facility. They need to remove the alcoholic beverage from that container, from this machine. Okay, that's the only thing I have to say about this. Don't get drunk while drinking from the soda machine. Okay, this will teach you how to open the door. Let's open the door. Don't click this because this will finish the tutorial. You can end the dialogue with this one and it will take you to the game. All across are training spots. Okay, we have a lot of things to cover right now, but the first thing I want to do is to go to the warehouse. This will teach you how to use the lockpick because wow. The lockpick skill was one of the things that they didn't teach you how to use, so this will be great for you, because in the beginning of the game, even if you don't kill the bandits, which you can do, which you can get your AK-47 and kill them, there is a lock chest in one of the sheds. And I'm only here to show you this. This is a little crafting tutorial, but I think it's badly made, to be honest. Because essentially they tell you to craft a broken bottle, right? So to craft a broken bottle you need bricks and a bottle. Fine, let's try that out. And you have crafted a broken bottle. By the way, they also added more recipes to the game, which I want to find, because I finally will get to make a crafting video. Right now the crafting is very underwhelming, because you don't have even the recipes to craft some of the higher things. And they're pretty lame in general. I mean, I don't want to say that they are bad, but except for the homemade grenades and the custom revolver, the other things are pretty, pretty bad. Also, the sniper rifle is pretty good, the magazine rifle, but by the time you get it, you can get something better. 046. Oh, come on, you put that right there. And okay, these crates are filled with ammo. Okay, you can open that safe. Hey! Developers, you should fix that. Uniform point duck glasses point. Okay. I didn't notice this one the first time I played it, so I thought I had to open the safe using my pick lock. But hey, the thing was right there. Okay, so this basically teaches you about lockpicking and crafting and some other stuff which are not really that interesting. And the base is pretty big, I mean, sleeping on duty. Okay, my pickpocketing is pretty high, my stealth is pretty high. Nimrod sleeping on the job. You also slash minutes again, and you keep it back. Okay, so that was funny. The tuning facility is pretty big. I mean, this is exactly what I wanted. You start off there. And the whole base is only protected by a single guy in the towers. By the way, they have a tank. Oh, look at this beautiful thing. Yep, this is a T battle tank. I don't know what model it is. Maybe they should write it somewhere, because I want to know. And they have two gates. Also, they have some machine guns and placements. This is a bunker in the mountain, by the way. And this light is flickering and will annoy you, so don't notice that. Don't notice that it will annoy you if you notice it. And this is more like a prison complex than a bunker. This is the shooting range. And let's go and meet Boris the Brave Guard. Hello, Boris. Maybe they should give him the combat armor, because he's on station on the combat post. The combat armor, and he has the rusty helmet. Maybe they should give him the new helmet. Actually, no, this more plays into the story, because people that are at the headquarters guarding it are getting the worst equipment. The best equipment are getting the people who are actually going outside. Okay, so this is the infirmary. Okay, you have some steam packs now. Let's speak to Comrade Doctor over here. Who has the picture of a backer? Okay, I have a few questions. Can you teach me something useful? Yeah, this is the one thing they should have taught you even from the beginning of the game. Now you know how to heal your companions and how to buff them. Pa But this means you'll get experience. I don't know if you keep the experience, but we'll see. I'm pretty sure they disabled the pickpocketing. So the NPCs, I don't think they will notice if you try to pickpocket them because they disable it for that guy. It would be funny if the base personnel would shoot you for pickpocketing people. Okay, let's get to this little area now. Let's get to the combat training of the game. Other than that, I don't think you can do anything else in here. That's the boxing ring. They have a boxing ring. Oh yeah, they will teach you how to eat. Delicious coffee. And tea. Nice. So let's make also some coffee. And it's like, I bet there are a lot of Russian guys and actually any other people in the world are trying to break the tutorial right now and find out some interesting facts about it. Is that a water bottle? Let's save the game. Is this a challenge? Oh, this is a challenge. I have to... If you want to try the tutorial, remember to make a melee build. So you want to see what happens when you beat him. Okay, so the tutorial also ends when you go in there for your briefing, but we still have a lot of things to explore. I wanted to see what happens if you beat him, but I guess that's your own secret to find out. So what's this? A training pistol? Oh, rubber bullets, that's interesting. So they have rubber bullets. Hey, can we get them into the game? Because I really want to shoot rubber bullets at people. Maybe we can stun them instead of killing them. Oh, the beautiful Dragunov. Oh, the training grenades. That's amazing. Yeah, these are explosive canisters. You can shoot them and they'll explode. They don't tell you this in the game and you almost never get to use them. Okay, he just follows you around, which is annoying. Well, I don't want to end the tutorial right now, I just want to see the other things. Okay, this is a nice way to practice. I mean, they'll show you what the distance is. Not a scratch. You have no chance of hitting that. In a way, this sounds like RoboCop's gun. That's so funny. Oh, nice, you can train with them. Let's not mention this ever again. Okay, let's win the combat. Not today. Actually, let's do it like this. Oh, the battle ends. Okay, that's nice. You can practice your combat. I think if you Come inside again. You can't pickpocket them. So you can test out the combat for as long as you like in there. That was nice, so you have the medical training, the pickpocketing and the crafting training. The lockpick, maybe you can... I wonder if there is any loot in there. This was amusing, you get to beat up your colleagues and shoot them with rubber bullets. Don't store your belongings in there, you're not the only bum who... Yeah, never store your items in the trash cans. Why did I suddenly become encumbered? I have no idea. Okay, now let's check out some other things. Yeah, so basically this is the whole Eton base, Eton training facility, don't call it the outside portion. And Boris is doing his job very well. Can we go and say hi to Boris? Oh no, I don't think we can, because those doors can't be opened. But there's a lot of fun time in here and you can test out a lot of things. Maybe you can build you can make a character build so you can beat this guy in melee combat and show off your supremacy. That would be hilarious. Other than that, there is nothing else to do here. I just want to see if you keep your experience when you go to the game. So you have, I have 100 experience right now. This was needed. I mean, I needed to see the Atom H quarters. Headquarters. Well, we can take a sneak peek through the windows. That's just a cafeteria. Now, I want to learn more about Atom and what they are doing and how they are training and what their equipment is, and this is the best way to do it. I mean, this looks amazing. Yeah, it kind of looks like a prison, but it looks like a real training camp. And it has a lot of space in it. Although the sandbags should not be such a big short block. Anyway, let's not talk about that. Let's see if the experience carries when you start the game. Oh, I have to get knocked down. I forgot about this. Okay, let's get knocked down. I didn't build my character to survive this fight, but I have a video on how to actually take the AK-47 and kill the bandits. And we're still drunk. They should fix this. This is hilarious. Leave me alone. Okay, he didn't leave me alone. Okay, but the tutorial tells you basically everything you need to know, and it is lacking some companion training. I mean, they should add some companion training in there. Yeah, so your experience does stay with you. So, if the developers are watching this, I suggest they add a companion training button. Or, I don't know, something like that. Something that will teach you how to control the companions. For example, walk out of the way or make them... I don't think you could have given orders to that guy. But anyway, it's not mentioned in the tutorial, so... If you can give orders to Alf while you're fighting the training combat with those two other guys, maybe they should tell you. Let's practice in your giving orders because you'll maybe one day lead a squad and they should tell you about the switching position, about the, you can tell them to go anywhere you like, you can tell them a target to choose, you can tell them a lot of things. But they should add that in the tutorial because a lot of people don't know about it. Okay, this is the chest I've been talking about, the crate. You can actually unlock that. But it's very good that you keep the experience from that, the tutorial zone. Because that's a big reason to do it. 100 experience is not... It's not so easy to get in the first part of the game. This has been my video and my ideas on the tutorial and the Atom Age quarters. It's amazing, but could use a little tweaking. Like the bug with the drunk... Okay, see you next time, bye.